Hey people, Paul McCulley again. Today's June 23rd, 2011 at 5:22 p.m. Eastern Time. People, I'm going to show you all something amazing, right? I'm going to show you all that I predicted. I'm not bragging. I'm just a mouthpiece of my Lord. I'm the scribe of my Lord, okay? So I'm just going to show you all that I predicted the revolution in the Middle East and the stuff that's going on today, all the storms and stuff that's going on, the tornadoes. I'm gonna prove it to you all, people, okay? This video, right, people, I uploaded December 2010, and YouTube, the government, they erased it, okay? They erased this video, they deleted it because they don't want you all to know the truth, okay? But I'm gonna prove to you all, people, that I actually called the Egyptian Revolution. I call it, people, okay? It's the name of the video. Another world breaking event. Finally, once and for all. Authentic truth about Nibiru, Planet X. Okay? I'm going to show you all the properties, okay, people? Look, the properties. Okay? Show it to you all. Okay? That's it. See the name of it? Okay. All things to talk about Nibiru, Planet X. Okay. Created Monday, December 13, 2010 at 4:29 a.m. Modified the same day. Access January 14, 2011. Okay, now people, keep those dates in mind, right? When you see this video, okay? Let me show you something else real quick. I'm gonna show you some of the video, but before I show it to you, let me show you something else real quick. Okay, the Tunisian Revolution began when? Okay. It began on December 17, 2010, right? And led to the oust of President Zine El, whatever it is, 28 days later, and the 14th of January. Is that a coincidence, people? Huh? Is that a coincidence? Okay. Hold on, let me, okay, the protests were sparked by the self-immolation of Mohammed, whatever his name is, on 17th December, and led to the oust of the president 28 days later, and 14th of January 2011. Okay? You see that? And back to the video. My video was created December 13th. That's 4 days before this guy set himself on fire. Right? And was accessed on the same day that the president of Tunisia was ousted. See? December 17th. December 13th. January 14th. January, I gotta go up, get off here. Okay, so now I'm going to show you a little bit of the video, right? I'm going to play you this video, okay, people? So I'm going to play a little bit of it to show you that it is the video. Okay?
Greetings, my people. My first name is Paul, which means small. My last... Greetings, my people. My first name is Paul, which means small. My last name is Mocker, which means who resembles God. So that, does that mean I'm a small God? Ha ha ha. Didn't you Christ said, ye are gods and sons of the Most High? So why do you wrinkle up your nose and put your thumbs down? Because I say I'm a God.
Okay, people, I'm going to stop it there. But the important part I want to show you guys, right, is the end part where I predicted the revolution and all that stuff, okay? So bear with me.
Thank you.
Here we go. I'm gonna show you just a little bit so you can see the same video.
Good night, sir. Yes, you're early tonight, huh? I just want to say thank you for the demonstration that you gave me over the weekend. I've seen these people in my last year.
See?
I will see things around. Thank you, me down. No, sir.
Listen, people.
You kept your promise, you didn't let me down. No, sir, because you start fooling the people.
See?
People. Start freeing the people.
So I said, people, now it's time for us to start freeing the people. Okay.
You kept your promise, you didn't let me down. Now it's time for us to start freeing the people. I've seen these people, my Lord. They're stiff-necked people. We have to give them a demonstration for them to start believing. We have to destroy them, my Lord. We have to harm them. We have to, if you harm them, and then even tighter for them to start believing. We have to destroy them.
So you see, people, now I'm gonna share the videos that I predicted the revolutions in the Middle East, okay? It's time for start freeing the people. And this video was erased by the government because they don't want you all to know who Paul McCultural is, okay? One love, enjoy the video. Well, yeah, there's some confusing information about Nibiru, okay? Because like I said, I was just learning about Nibiru anyway, so I was just speaking about what I was learning about Nibiru. So my interpretation of Nibiru has not changed, it just has evolved to a better understanding, okay? So never mind some of the junk I talk about what Nibiru is. I was just speaking about what I read and how I understood it to be. But the important part is the end of the video. You could skip all that stuff and go to the end. Alright, one love.
Greetings, my people. My first name is Paul, which means small. My last name is Mocker, which means who resembles God. So that, does that mean I'm a small God? Ha ha ha. Didn't you Christ said, ye are gods and sons of the Most High? So why do you wrinkle up your nose and put your thumbs down? Because I say I'm a God. What am I, dirt? Am I garbage? We are gods, can't we create? Can't we do things that the animals cannot do? So we are gods. We're proud of that. Be proud that you are God. And don't wrinkle up your nose and put your thumbs down, okay? Now, the purpose of this video right here, right now, right, is to tell you all about this thing called Nibiru. Now, you all have been given misinformation about Nibiru. And now, because of that misinformation, you have got the wrong interpretations. Nibiru is not a death star or any destructive force coming to annihilate Earth. On the contrary, Nibiru has come for the total opposite.
and I have been given a responsibility to tell you guys the message from Nibiru and to remove all your fears and all your doubts about Nibiru. Now, there's only one type of person who have any reason to fear Nibiru. Mostly those are who are in power, you know, like the Pope and them and the governments and them, you know what I'm talking about. But there's people also who need to fear Nibiru. Here's a question you must ask. Is your heart light like a feather? Or is it heavy as lead? Light like a feather, heavy as lead. I know I can't sing, but you get the point what I'm trying to say. Is your heart light like a feather? Or is it heavy as lead? Now, that's how you know whether or not you should fear Nibiru. Now, let me give you the true interpretations of Nibiru. Okay, and this is from Wikipedia, the free online encyclopedia. All you have the right is to do your own research instead of sitting there and letting the government and mischievous people give you misinformation. Do the research. Okay, Nibiru is nothing destructive. Okay, Nibiru, Babylonian astronomy. Nibiru, also translated Neburu, is a term in the Akkadian language translating to crossing or point of transition, especially of rivers. Example, river crossing or ferry boats. In Babylonian astronomy, Nibiru is a term of the highest point of the ecliptic. Example, the point of summer surface and its associated constellation. The establishment of the point of Nibiru is described in the type of the creation epic Enuma Elis. When Murdoch fixed the location Manzazu of Nibiru, inland and air in the sky, as the highest point in the path of the planets, Nibiru was considered the seat of the Sumus Deus, who pastured the stars like sheep. In Babylonian, identified Marduk. This interpretation of Marduk as the ruler of the cosmos, suggesting an early monotheistic tendency in Babylonian religion by various authors. The correspondent constellation was in the area of Libra. So you see, people, Nibiru is supposed to be in the area of Libra, right? The Nibiru constellation rose in the month of Tisritum around autumnal equinox, so around maybe the autumn time, so October, November, around that time. And Nibiru was also named for the planet Jupiter when observed in the month of Tisritum, which is around the autumn. So you see, people, Nibiru was also the name of the planet Jupiter. Is Jupiter a dead star? In the enumeration, Nibiru is mentioned at different astronomical locations in the conjunction with the position of stars and planets. Okay. Mostly as the star of Marduk. So Nibiru was also called the star of Marduk. Marduk, how you want to pronounce it? Okay, Marduk. As in the Enuma Elish, Nibiru is Marduk's star, which he made appear in the heavens. The stars of heaven, let him, Nibiru, set their course. Let him shepherd all the gods like sheep. So you see, people, Nibiru was a star that it's like the leaders. Okay, now think about Sirius, right? Think about Sirius and the Orion. Right, Sirius is like the big dog, right? And Orion is leading the chase, right? Sirius is shepherding Orion. So Sirius can also be considered Nibiru, because I say, Nibiru, the son of heaven, let him, Nibiru, set your course. Let him shepherd all the gods like sheep. Now, people, for the past couple of weeks, right, I've been watching Jupiter, right? And if you notice, Jupiter rises in the east and sets in the west. So Jupiter is actually leading all the stars towards the west, even Sirius, Orion, okay? Jupiter leading all the stars, like he's shepherding them, but he's leading the pack, and behind the pack is the star that you guys say is Venus, the new star that's in the east, the morning star. That star is the one who's, it's heading up the chase. It's the last star that rises in the morning. So the first star that rises is Jupiter, that leads all the stars towards the west, and this star, Venus or whatever it is the one who's in the back. So what I'm reading here, right, it corresponds to what I'm showing you guys, people. The stars of heaven, let him, the bull, set their course. So Jupiter right now is setting the course of all the stars. I watch it every night. Let him shepherd all the gods like sheep. Okay. The various stars are planet or not subject to any fixed interpretation. Okay. The star of Air, for example, was described at various relevant spots, including Vela, Farmerhart, and Venus. So Venus was also considered Nibiru also. Similar interpretations were made for the other stars of the gods. So certain celestial coordinates were where the stars of the gods appear must be considered. Okay. Nibiru is described more closely on a complete cuneiform tablet. Nibiru, which is said to have occupied the passageway of heaven and earth, because everyone above and below asks Nibiru if they cannot find the passage. So you see, people, Nibiru was like a post, like a think about a ship coming into a storm, can't find its port, and he sees this light flashing, a beacon of hope. That's Nibiru, okay? Nibiru, which is said to have occupied the passageway of heaven and earth, because everyone above and below asks Nibiru if they cannot find the passage. Okay? Nibiru is Merlin's star, which the gods in heaven cause to be visible. Okay? Now think about it, people. Venus is like a ghost, okay? One moment Venus could be acting as the morning star in the east, right? The next minute, it's acting as the evening star in the west, like an apparition. Okay, so Nibiru is Moloch's star, which the gods in heaven cause to be visible. Nibiru stands as a post at the turning point. The others serve Nibiru the post, the one who crosses the middle of the sea without calm. May his name be Nibiru, for he takes the center of it. Okay, so the star that crosses the middle of the sea, crosses the middle of the sky then, completely, from one end to the next. What does that, people? Jupiter. Okay, Jupiter rises in the east and it goes all the way to the west. It actually sets in the west. That means everyone in the world can see it. And it's leading all the stars. So the one who crosses the middle of the sea without calm, may his name be Nibiru, for he takes up the center of it. The path of the stars of the sky should be kept unchanged. What part of the star kept unchanged? Jupiter. Okay. Jupiter has the same path from east to west. East to west. It doesn't change its course. Not in this time. Okay? So this also depends on the time period. So right now, in November and December, Jupiter has not changed its course. Its path has remained unchanged. And it keeps moving from east to west, and everyone in the world sees it. Okay, so now, Nibiru in the Molapin, Nibiru is identified as Jupiter. Okay, people, Jupiter and Nibiru. When the stars of Enlil have been finished, one big star, although its light is dim, divides the sky in half and stands there. That is the star of Merlin. Nibiru, Jupiter. It keeps changing its position across the sky. Okay? So, people, which star keeps changing its position across the sky? Jupiter right now, it keeps changing from east to west. Keep changing its position across the sky. What also does that? Venus. Venus is the one who is heading up the chase right now. So we know Nibiru have come. Jupiter is Nibiru and Venus is the new star, kind of. Now they're driving Jupiter. Jupiter was the power source, okay? Jupiter was the star of control, I guess, all the other planets. Whatever is going on in outer space, right, it have a lot to do with Jupiter. Whatever is going on Earth have a lot to do with Jupiter. Now, it's about to change. Jupiter is no longer the power source. Jupiter is no longer the star of murder. Now it's Venus. So what that means now is that there is a drastic change in our universe. Mankind is about to elevate to a higher understanding because Christ has been taken off the cross.
Serious, you early tonight, huh? I just want to say thank you for that demonstration that you gave me over the weekend. Thank you. It was powerful. It was awesome. I seen my star. Thank you. Thank you. You kept your words. You kept your promise. You said if I trust you, I will see things, beautiful things beyond my imagination. Thank you. Thank you, Sirius. Thank you, Rara. Thank you. You kept your promise, you didn't let me down. Now it's time for us to start freeing the people. I've seen these people, my lord. They're stiff-necked people. You might have to give them some demonstration for them to start believing. Do not destroy them, my lord. Do not harm them. If you harm them, they will only cling even tighter to their false beliefs. So let's get them with love. Persuasion is better than force. Let's persuade them, my lord. Persuasion is better than force. You taught me that, remember? So I look forward to the demonstration later on tonight, in the morning. I'm gonna shut off right now for now, okay?
So you people, you are looking at the video I made December 13th, 2010, and I uploaded it, and it was removed, deleted by YouTube, whoever hacked it. So anyway, the point is, when I put the cities in the video, right, and the lightning and the thunder, I'm sending spiritual vibes for the revolution. Okay, that spiritual vibe was sending on people. Honestly, spiritual vibes. Time to free the people. I was asking my Lord to use weather and spiritual vibe, because in America it's the weather, and in Christendom, Japan, all those places, we're using the weather to free the people. England and all that place, weather, because the people are not pick up arms, so we're using the weather, and we don't want them to pick up arms either. In the Middle East, they pick up arms against their people and they start marching. Okay, that was the significance of me putting these tornadoes over these cities. As you can see, the pretty lightning, that's a tornado, people. Okay, the only thing I added to this video was the music, to give emphasis to my voice. Okay, that's the only thing I added to this video new, is the music. Everything is as is. I made this video December 13, 2010, and this is how you've seen it. I added nothing else to it. So it's proof, people, that if a man is righteous in his heart and in his intention, he can call upon the powers of the Creator and the powers of the universe to do his will. And my will is being done. My will is that the people be freed from these tyrannical rulers and these religious liars. Okay, so my will is being done by the powers of the Most High. They're helping me because they know that I'm righteous. I don't want to rule nobody. I just want to free everybody so we could rule each other. We could rule ourselves equally.
I saw your bird.
Okay? I don't want to rule you, no. I don't want to fool you, no. I don't want to school you. Things you may not never know about. You know? One love. My video was created December 13th. That's 4 days before this guy set himself on fire, right? And with access, and the same day that the president of Tunisia was ousted. See? December 17th. December 13th, January 14th, January, I gotta go out, get off here. Okay, so now